majestic and matchless God. Good morning, Father. Good morning to the one who laid us down last night and rose us up this night. Good morning to the one who receives our praise and hears our prayer. Good morning to the one who has set the captives free. Good morning to my Savior and my salvation. Lord, have your way. This is not about me, this is all about you. Let your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Anybody excited this morning? In our pastor's absence, in our first family, I would like to thank them for trusting me to bring the word on this Sunday. I had to play twice. Pastor asked me, Lexi, can you preach next Sunday? I said, and you're not here? He said, no, I'm not here. I said, you sure you want to do that? He said, yeah, I'm sure. So we thank God for them. We thank God for you being here. Give yourselves a round of applause. Amen. Is that how you feel about yourself? Just that little bit? Come on, you're better than that. You're special. You're something God made. Individually, divinely, pure.
Yeah.
God is so, so good. Amen. Thank you to my wife and my family and my spiritual family and all those who have prayed for me over this last week and praying for me now. Amen. Amen. You know, I chuckled to myself. People found out I was preaching today. And a young lady asked me last night, well, she didn't ask, she stated, I can't wait to find out what the song is for tomorrow. Am I that predictable? I guess I am. I told y'all I was. Amen. We get ready to play the song. But before we play the song, when you hear the song, before you just start getting into it, listen to the words. Listen to the lyrics. You can find God in anything. Amen?
Yes, amen.
Amen. Becomes, what are you running from? Anybody in here running from anything? Nobody. Not a soul. Nobody running from anything.
No.
You all are. You may not know it. Glory be to God. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot to get my housekeeping notes. This is a short message. It's hot in here. I know how Mr. Bill felt last week. But I tell you the truth. If we don't get a few amens and a hallelujah and some preaching, go ahead and say so, and that's real, we might be healed by it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. What are you running from? 1 Timothy 6 and 11 from the NIV. This is Brother Paul talking to the young minister in training, Timothy. And this is his final charge to Timothy, because 1 Timothy 6 is the last book and last chapter in 1 Timothy. Amen. And it says, but you, and come on, y'all, we're going to make it applicable to today. But you is not Timothy. But you is you. But Pam. But Terry. But Tammy. Man, old woman of God. She gave you a title. Flee. You know what it is to flee? Move away quickly. Flee from all this. What are you running away from? Some of you all still thinking, I don't have anything that I need to run away from. I'm good. Still in 1 Timothy verses 2 through 5, 2 says, these are the things that you are to teach and insist on. What are those things? Well, 1 Timothy 6 and 1 says that you, as a believer, are to not show slight against non-believers that may be your masters just because they don't believe. We're going to help you understand. In that translation, take the word master and exchange it for someone who may have authority over you. A parent, a supervisor, a pastor, anybody in that realm. It also says, even if your master does believe, you still shouldn't have slight against them because they made you a slave. You should be grateful that they do believe so that they may treat you fairly in the heart of God as a Christian. These are the things you are to teach and insist on. And Paul, in all his wisdom, says, if anyone teaches otherwise, other than what we just said, and does not agree with the sound instruction of the Lord Jesus Christ and to godly teachings, here are the things that we're running from. They are conceited, full of themselves, and understand nothing, ignorant. Anybody know anybody like that? They have, I should turn and look at the screen for this part, because I don't want to make eye contact, because I might offend somebody. They have an unhealthy interest in controversies and quarrels about words that result in envy, strife, malicious talk, and evil suspicions. What is he saying there? He's saying if you agree and have a passion and an interest in reality TV, this is what you're doing. And 5 says constant. Constant means not to end. Friction means always, not good. Between people of corrupt minds. Notice it did not say minds, it said mind. Because there is only one mind for the enemy.
Yes.
And one mind for the kingdom of glory.
Yes.
So if your mind isn't of the kingdom of glory, your mind is of the enemy. And it is corrupt. Who have been robbed of the truth. Y'all hear that? And think that godliness is a means to financial gain. What are we running from? We're running from false teachers and a love of money. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
So for the scientists and the engineers and the engineerers in the room, you know that there's an action, there must be a reaction. So if you're running from something, you should be running to something. I'm glad y'all
say it.
So what is it that you're running to? What is it that you think you might be? What is it that, ooh, if I could only? Some of us are confused. We've all seen this. Some of us had to recite it in class, stand in front of the class, read it out loud, and say it with some passion, and it's all a lie. Because when you know your history, you know that this was not for everyone. We hold these truths, which turned out to be lies, to be self-evident. They are not when you're being called by cops or before going to blues while being black. Huh. Somebody ought to say amen. That all men are created equal. If you're white, blonde, and blue eyed, that they were endowed by their creator. My God didn't say so. Not that way. With certain unalienable rights. If that was the case, all the aliens from South America would be allowed here. They're cutting them off at the border. Rights that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This was written by a slave owner who had a black concubine and had many, many children by it. He didn't believe his own words. But a lot of us, the point I'm making, a lot of us are in the actual pursuit of happiness. And I am here to tell you and declare and decree today, you don't know what happiness is. It's all right to pursue happiness, but you need to have another pursuit prior to. That's a good word right there. This is what the pursuit of happiness looks like. I got the job, I got the house, I got the expensive German car, 2.5 kids, a dog, a white picket fence, a 401k, extra money coming in, houses on the side. I am set. I am happy. At least I think so. I'm just as miserable as I can be. Because if you look closely, you'll see that the pursuit of happiness is entangled in a web of strength. Take a minute and absorb your happiness. If you're running away from something, you just ought to be running to better.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
When I interviewed for my new job, and I talked to the the HR lady, she asked, what would keep you from taking this job? And I said, I want the job. I want that to be known. But what would keep me from taking the job is if you offer me less money than what I'm making now. Some of y'all act like y'all don't understand.
Take your time.
My late mama used to teach us that if you walk in and you step in some dog poo, you don't back up to look at what you stepped in. When you step in it, you step forward and turn around and look back. Because if you step back, you might step into it again.
Say so.
So you should be running to bed. Life is full of choices. Is your preference to be happy or to be God? If you go right, see what I did there? Right. If you go right, the left will be added unto you. But some of us, all we see is glitz, glam, and dollar signs.
That's real. Say so.
And we lean on our own understanding, and we lean to the left, and we lean away from our faith. There is but one way.
That's right.
And pursue what we're running to. Righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. That's what we're running to when we're running away from false prophets and money-hungry leaders. It's all right to leave your church if your pastor, the administration, is focused on false teaching to get you to be a certain way and digging in your pocket for financial gain.
Go ahead, great.
That's the wrong way.
Glory to God.
Paul says to Timothy, these are the things that make a true man or woman of God. Anybody ever went the wrong way on a one-way street?
Yeah.
And you know you did it.
That's right.
You were guilty when you thought to do it. But you did it anyway. So I'm here to tell you, it's one way only.
That's right. Yeah.
There are no ifs, ands, buts, or exceptions.
That's right.
One way and one way only. Ephesians. Somebody say this is a good word.
This is a good word.
When you heard about Christ when you were 17 years old and get ready to be a freshman at AT&T, North Carolina State, wherever you went, when you wanted to be saved, you had a desire to be saved, and you heard about Christ and were taught in him. And when you got down there and did something you knew you didn't have to do, you felt bad and you crumbled. But the truth of the matter was your conviction.
I love it. Yes, it was. Yes, it was.
Meant that God was with you.
That's right.
In accordance with the truth that Minister Cecilia tried to get you to understand a few weeks ago, that is in Jesus. You were taught when you first joined the fellowship in the kingdom of God. You were taught with regard to your own stinky, nasty self. To do what Minister Carolyn told you to do is take off that mask. And if you listen, she told you it was corrupt and deceitful. And full of the wrong kind of desires. 23 says to be made new in the attitude of your mind. Change your mind. And put on the new self. Created to be like God in true righteousness and holiness. What are we running away from? If you haven't figured it out yet, we're running away from ourselves. Some of y'all don't get that on the way home. John 14 and 6 says, Jesus is the way, Jesus is the truth, and Jesus is the eternal life that you and I see. I told you there was only one way.
That's it.
So godly pursuits are what we're talking about today. You can make that the topic of your notes. Godly pursuits. Notice it's in green. I play all kinds of mental games when I'm putting this together. What green represent? What else it represent? Thank you. Go. Did you notice what you should be fleeing from was in red? Pursue. To strive. Strive means to struggle or fight. And press to gain. Didn't we just say if you're running away from something, you should be running to better?
Yeah.
Gain is not bad.
Yeah.
Gain is better.
Amen.
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 Seek to attain or accomplish what you're going after. Spoiler alert, your salvation. One thing that I desire.
Go ahead, say so.
Hallelujah.
That I may sit in the temple.
Hallelujah. Lord.
Face to face.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Anything else that you put to attain or accomplish, if it's not that, you made a left. Mm-hmm. To proceed in accordance with a method or a master plan to chase after someone or something. I'm doing both.
Amen.
I'm chasing after Jesus and the prize he has for me. To follow in hot pursuit. My police officer, what's the code for pursuit? Is there a police code for pursuit? No? Just hold the radio. I got it. Amen. This is the third time you've seen this slide. This is the third time God wants you to get what you're running to.
Yeah.
Pursue. Strive after, fight for, struggle to get to righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. Righteous. The quality of being morally right or justified. How you doing, sister? Righteous, sanctified, and saved in my Jesus. And that's all right. is securing and holding on for dear life to your own salvation. And that's only half of it. Righteousness is helping somebody else who might be struggling in their walk to achieve and latch on to their salvation. Godliness. If I'm going too fast, y'all let me know. I know y'all want to write these down. Y'all let me know. The quality of being devoutly religious, piety. Anybody know any godly people? See, y'all thinking about it. Y'all thinking about it. There are some monks who don't talk. All they do is pray. And when they pray, they worship. And they go to the temple. And that's all they do. You would want to think, those are some godly brothers. They don't have sex. They don't get married. They I haven't met the godly person. But the scripture did not say to become godly. Y'all better pay attention. The scripture says to pursue godliness.
About me and my giving.
Thank you, brother. It is true. Because I was a selfish, stubborn little brat. When I was growing up, everything had to be about me. And when I realized this ain't it, I used to hide my stuff from my brother. Because I ain't want them in my stuff. I was selfish. I'm not selfish anymore.
Praise God.
Amen. Endurance. Perseverance. Let me throw another word up in there. Patience. Continue. Never stop. Effort. Work.
That's real.
Never stop working to do or achieve something despite the difficulties. I'm gonna build a house. I don't have a hammer. I don't have a saw. What am I gonna do? Endure. Failures. Five times, every time I failed, I'll be rich. But the victory is I kept trying. I kept going. You ever get a made up mind that you ain't finished until it's finished? Endure. Or opposition. The devil's gonna come at you. We'll do it. PSA right here, I want to thank Mr. Spam and Kenny for putting on an ultimate and wonderful, wonderful marriage conference on yesterday. It was truly, truly a blessing. I will be honest with you because that's what I do. I did not want to go. Nothing personal. I've been married 23 years. I got a life sentence. I've been doing my time like I'm supposed to do. I love my wife loves me. I would lay down my life for her. I don't need somebody to tell me, you got to be gentle. I don't need that. But when you endure,
amen.
Despite my own opposition, I went and I got blessed. And I can safely say, everyone who went was blessed. Amen. And another plug, the other wife did all the cooking. Woo! I tell you what, burn, baby, burn. Amen. Endure. It ain't that bad. Keep going. Keep going. No pain, no gain. Gentleness. The quality of being kind. You can't buy quality for yourself. You can't go to the store and say, yeah, let me get 2.5 pounds of quality. Can you spice it up a little bit? It doesn't work like that. So you have to grow into quality. It has to be sincere and heartfelt. Your kindness. Being tender. Not when somebody asks you a question. Because you might have had a bad day. Mild man. Ain't nobody being bothered with no wild man. Ain't nobody got time for that. Every time somebody approaches you, get bothered too, brother. Like you're some kind of wombat or something. Softness. Not only in touch, but in speech. In caring for somebody. In greeting somebody. How you doing? A little too much. Lightness. I went and got a mani-pedi yesterday. Last night, something. Yesterday. You did that on my own too. Yesterday before the marriage conference, I went and got a mani pedi, and the young lady who did it is Cecilia's technician. I had never used her before. And I get tense, especially when they get near my feet because I'm ticklish. And you know, I get tense, I start kicking her. And she just gently and softly and caring as she could, she turned my foot where she wanted it. She scrubbed all that old dead dry skin off of her. And she was gentle. And she just looked at me and smiled. And the tickle just went away for a minute. Anyway, yeah, enough about my personal life. What am I running to? What are we running to? Y'all see, Jesus, what emotion is evoked when you see this picture? Endurance, righteousness, love, kindness, godliness. But what you don't see is the suffering, the pain, the discourse, the discord, the trouble. And the Bible clearly states that he who was without sin inherited all of the sin for us. Think about that. And think about in your running towards better, you need to go the same route. Third date, ball on our own 45. We need a critical first down. Everybody in the building know we're passing. So, Mrs. Trisha, I want you to run up and an out. Up and an out. On three. So when we get to the line of scrimmage and the play is activated, if Mrs. Trisha runs an in, and a curl, we're not going to get to where we need to be. We're not going to be successful. When you do it your way, you fail.
That's good. Preach. That's real good right there.
But truth be told, when you do the way that the master called the play, you don't complete the pass, there's a chance for pass interference because you were. What I'm trying to say is it may not always happen the way you think it's going to happen, but it's the result. This last scripture, y'all, I told y'all it was short. Basically, what Timothy 6, 20 through 21 is saying is, keep on moving. Don't stop. Pursue godliness because your destination is not your destiny. Timothy, Larea, Kenny, my wife, Cecilia, Lolita, and whoever else, put your name where Timothy is. Guard what has been entrusted to your care. Take care of the word that I poured into your heart. Guard it as though your life depends on it. Turn away. Turn away from godless chatter. Hello? Hey, how are you? I'm good, how are you?
I'm good.
I just called to say, did you see Cedric having on shorts and shirts today? He knew better than to come to church. glory to God. My line. See how fast we did that? Hey, good morning. How was your weekend?
Man, dog got out,
ran down the street, had to get in the car and chase. You know what? I gotta send an email. I'm gonna holler at you later. If it's not talking about the glorification of the Lord, you are wasting your time.
That's the truth. Lunch conversation.
We played a game last night at the marriage retreat. I told y'all it was good. Y'all missed it. What's the name of the game? Can you hear me? Hearing this. So the game is when you take a husband and a wife and you sit them across from each other, and one has a stack of cards and has to slowly mouth what's on the card. But the other spouse is sitting across from you with music playing in the environment and headphones on that's full of noise.
Yes.
Godless chatter. Mm-hmm. Every single person who put their headphones on said, this stuff is giving me a headache.
Yeah.
That's how you should feel when you hear godless chatter.
Yeah.
And especially from your brothers and sisters in Christ. Turn away from meaningless, non-benevolent, weightless, godless chatter, and the opposing ideas. Those opposing ideas are anything against what we just talked about. If somebody wants to tell you, I know the Bible says there's only one way to God, but God made all kinds of people in all kinds of religions, so it's just not one way. Come on, you smarter than that, Minister Andre. Actually, I'm not, because I'm crazy stupid believing what God has taught me. So if you want to come to my event and ask people to form a circle and rub their hands together and push out some energy towards the person you talk about, I'm not participating because it's not in my mind. Opposing ideas. Ding dong. Watchtower. Hold on. Lele Cassius want to join us. Those are my dogs. 250 pounds of good. And the opposing ideas. Anything against God is an opposing idea. Here's the good part. Of what is falsely called knowledge.
All right.
I'm smart. I got a BA, a BS, an MBA, an MD, a PhD, an MSA, a CPA, a BCOP, but I do not have KESUS. I have knowledge, but no substance. I've learned my way into a religion or belief that I might have or might not have created on my own. I'm too smart to believe that some man born to a virgin in a dirty manger grew up to have a ministry and had 12 people who stupidly followed him all the way to the cross where he died. What? I'm that sold out.
All right.
You can have all your knowledge. You can have 32 degrees below zero. But if you ain't got Jesus,
say so.
You have nothing. Ancient Aliens on the Discovery Channel. Anybody else watch that? And we laugh because when they can't explain God,
yes, sir.
The new trend is they make everything terrestrial.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Everything is an alien came and did it. The aliens built the temples. The aliens built the pyramid. The aliens did this. The aliens did that. The aliens, the aliens, the aliens. Last night they had the audacity to say that God himself was an alien.
My God.
You ought to flee from false teachings. Well, Minister Harris, why are you and your wife watching? So that we can be equipped to tell you the truth.
That's my idea.
They present it as though they are facts. And they are not. Some have professed, and in so doing, have departed from the faith. You too smart that you lost God. You let your head overturn your heart's desire. You basically told God, you know what? It was good when I didn't know. Knowledge. But now that I think that I know, I'm changing my mind. Because it's not to know, it's to believe.
That's right.
Knowledge and belief are two different things. My mother used to say, "You're so smart, you dumb." Never knew it was scripture. Read it right there. You so smart, you're dumb.
Say so, say so.
Nobody see that but me? Right there. False knowledge. You so smart, depart from the faith. You dumb.
Yeah.
Running away. I need it. I know you need it. Some rejuvenation. I'll tell the truth. Running away. I'm leaving a bad situation because I'm running away. And I'm going to battle.
That's right.
I don't like talking about people. So I won't talk about people, I'll talk about this situation. Close friend and family told us at their church. They take an offering in the 300 kids church. They instruct the parents to make sure you give your babies money so that they can participate in the offering for the 300 church. And another close brother of mine who goes to a different church who says that they take an offering every time the door opens. If the church name is on it, they're taking an offering. Bible study. Sunday morning prayer. Afternoon prayer, evening prayer, church one, church two, church three. I'm finished anyway. Every time you hit the church with the doors and they're open, will you come? Will you come? Will you come and join this establishment? We don't care about your well-being, we don't care about your righteousness. As long as you can give whatever you can give, when you can give it, when we ask you to give it, you are more than welcome in this place. Will you come? Because I have attributed money with godliness. The more money I have, the godlier I can pretend to be. I need a Learjet so that I can go to my speaking engagements all around the country and the world. And the Lord has told me to tell you, my people, to pay for it. can't just say they bought the jet. They bought another jet. Then they bought a helicopter because the airport was too far away to drive to. So he needed the helicopter and the helipad at the church to go from the church to the airport, from the airport to my private jet. I am fleeing anything opposing the beliefs and design structure system of my salvation in Jesus Christ. I'm fleeing that. And I am fleeing any man who said, thank God for this message. I would like for you to stand. Will you stand? Will you stand? And if you got $100 for today's service, I would like for you to form a line right here. If you got $50, I want you to come on and stand right here. But if you can get more than 100, just come right on up front. Set the count of money as they bring it so that we know how much they're giving, because I have a goal in mind. And if I don't reach that goal, I'm going to keep asking you to keep bringing more money. How do you all expect for us to be godly if you don't give us the money that we're requesting? False appearances. I go to, y'all like the way I get there. Don't they have about 15,000 people there? Yeah. Do you know the pastor? I know his name. No. Have you ever talked to him?
No.
Has he ever talked to you?
No.
Can you show him your appointment?
No.
Why you go there? They got good music. Do you know, what's his name? Jonathan Slater is over there. He's a musical director. I'm running away. This message may not be for you. Pam said it last night. She sits in church and says, oh, I was throwing so-and-so so they can hear this. I wish they was here too. But I'm glad and thankful that you're here. Because we are the delivered bird. Or at least we should be. If you sit here Sunday after Sunday and the benediction is called, you run out, grab your snack and your juice and hit the streets and don't share the goodness of the Lord with anybody from Sunday to Sunday, guess what? You're a false witness. Of the holy and righteous word of God. I went to work Monday. My office mate hurt his back a couple of weeks ago. I said, how you doing, brother? How's your back? He's from Puerto Rico. So his response was, Poppy! I'm good, Poppy. I gotta take it one day at a time, Poppy. One day at a time. My back is good, but I'll get there. And he looked at me and he said, I'm not complaining. It is what it is. I said, I'm glad you're not complaining, because Minister Bill just told on yesterday that we should not complain. It's all right to vent to a certain extent, but don't complain, because when you complain, you're telling God he can't do what he is able to do. That was my witness. I hope and pray that each and every Sunday, you gain something that you can take on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday. I'm high. The screen went out, but the last thing Paul said to Timothy, he basically chucked the deuce. He said, peace and grace to you all. Amen. Amen.